send it up again. And there's that lovely lady. And there's my gent. How are you? Thank you. No more. Thank you. Welcome once again to your big Saturday game show of 3-2-1, the last in the present series. Now, but wait a minute. We'll be back with you again in December. We look forward to that, so please make that a date. But even though it's the last show in our series, folks, we do have some very interesting people here in the studio again. We have a party of Avon ladies here. Where are they? Avon ladies, and they're protesting about a new housing estate. Every front door's got a knocker. But folks, the theme of our last show is a special theme. It's a five-actor, the Lilac Pimpernel. Right now, we'd like you to come along and meet our resident booby prize, our own little metal monsieur, our canned canister from Cairns, Dusty Bin. Here he is. Come on, Dust. Whoa. And look at that. Splendid. As always, splendid, dressed up in the theme there with his tricorn hat. But wait a minute, Dusty, the Lilac Pimpernel is one thing. But during this series, you've been quite clever. You've blown whistles, you've played bugles, you've waved flags, but that gun doesn't really work, does it, Dust? No, you see, I mean, he can't really do anything, you ask. If it really worked, well, I mean, he wouldn't be in the show because you can't get that, can you really, Dust, from anybody? I bet you... And now, if you'd like to come along and meet, as always, most important people on our show, our contestants, say hello to them. Here they are.
Martin and Jacqueline Reeve from Colchester. Paul and Barbara Brennan from Oldham. Barry and Brenda Haller from Aylesbury.
And away we go, of course, with our quiz. Remember, two rounds of questioning. Whatever they win at the end of the first round is what they play for each correct answer in the second round. And our first couple this evening are Barry and Brenda Haller. And you're from Ickford, which is Aylesbury. Yes,
that's right.
Not too far from my part of the world. I did national service at Holton. Do you know that place?
Yes.
Yes, where I did. Shows you how old I am. However, listen, Barry, sales manager.
Yeah.
Yes, and
sure.
For what?
Well, it's a company that manufactures and exhibits cleaning equipment. We sell cleaning equipment and materials.
Now, Brenda, what about you? Does he do all the cleaning at home, or is it
no,
you?
No, you're joking. He never touches it.
Brenda, you like going to auctions and markets, and you once bought two horses at the time you were 8 months pregnant.
That's right.
That's a funny sort of craving, isn't it?
Well, it's better than coal.
Yes.
Right.
Cass, can you imagine that? Two new horses while you were 8 months pregnant. I bet you were getting kicked from all angles.
I was, all over the place.
God, do you have the horses now, still?
No, Barry made me sell them.
Oh, there you are.
Right. Yes.
Oh, well, that's the way it is. Good luck. Glad you're here. Let's have your questions and making a return to our show this week. Tina Robinson is back with us. Tina, how are you? Nice. We know you're coming out in the Bond film. We keep talking about that, but I keep seeing you on one of those adverts where you wash yourself down.
That's
and you
right.
get in the coach and you say, what do you say?
We leave at 3.
That's the one. Lovely. You're here. Would you like to take one of those 3, please? Thank you very much. Okay, Brenda. Now, you know we like you to answer alternately. Ladies first. If you don't know an answer, say don't know and pass. Believe me, you can build up your score that way, but I must accept the first answer you give me, and we have two ways of stopping you if you make a mistake or run out of time. So for £10 for each correct answer, your question is about international statesmen and politicians and their countries. We will give you the name of the politician, and we want you to give us their country. Now, Julius Nyerere is the president of Tanzania. So that's what we'll start you with. Julius Nyerere and...
Tanzania.
Charles de Gaulle.
France.
Yuri Andropov.
Russia.
Mahatma Gandhi.
Don't know.
Eamon de Valera.
Don't know.
Mao Zedong.
Don't know.
Benito Mussolini.
Don't know.
Konrad Adenauer.
Don't know.
Robert Menzies.
Don't know.
Henry Kissinger.
America.
Indeed. Henry Kissinger. America. Robert Menzies was Australia. Konrad Adenauer was Germany, West Germany. Benito Mussolini was Italy. Yes, indeed. Mao Zedong was China. Eamon de Valera was the era, or the Republic of Ireland, of course. Mahatma Gandhi was India. So at the end of the first round, you got 4 right, £40. That's not a bad start. Four to start with. Now, Martin and Jacqueline Reeve, who are from Coggeshall, which I know is Colchester, isn't it?
Sorry.
Yeah, we've got friends who live at Colchester. Now, several jobs you've had, Martin. At the moment, you work for the Ministry of Defence.
Yes.
But you've been a petrol pump attendant and a vehicle mechanic.
That's right.
And Jacqueline, your job sounds interesting. Tell us about that. What do you do?
I work in a firm that makes isinglass, which is used in the clarification of beer.
And what's clarification of beer? What does that mean?
It makes the suspended matter drop to the bottom. It's
suspended matter in beer? You'd never drink again, would you?
It's actually a fish bladder.
Oh, is it? Well, I'm really glad I don't drink now. But I love your mutual hobby. It's really, that really takes some beating. Tell them what you do. What's your hobby?
We keep cockatiels and canaries.
Uh-huh. And it says here that you have 24 canaries in your spare bedroom.
That's right, yes.
If I had 24 canaries, I'd go spare in any room. You got five more in your living room and two in the kitchen.
That's
right. So how many in all is that? I mean,
about 40, I think.
Geez. What's it like? I mean, what time do they start singing in the morning?
About 5 a.m.
And you don't mind that?
No, the neighbours don't mind, either.
I don't think they've got any option in that, do you? I mean, I do know that a lot about birds because you can have a breed, can't you, and a strain. Mm-hmm. And the difference is, if you cross a canary with a budgie, it's a breed. And if you cross a canary with a parrot, it's a strain. It would be, wouldn't it? Let's have your questions. Can we have them, please? Thank you very much, Tina. One of those two is yours. Which one?
Thank you.
Okay, Jackie, thanks a lot. Tina, so for £10 for you for each correct answer, your question, again, is about international statesmen and politicians and their countries. We will give you the name of the politician and we want you to give us their country. Now, Dom Mintoff has been Prime Minister of Malta for many years. We'll start you with that one. Dom Mintoff and...
Malta.
François Mitterrand.
Don't know.
Leonid Brezhnev.
Russia.
Ronald Reagan.
America.
Ayatollah Khomeini.
Don't know.
Francisco Franco.
Don't know.
Charles Hohe.
Don't know.
Robert Mugabe.
Don't know.
Chou En Lai.
Don't know.
Helmut Kohl.
Germany.
Yes, indeed. West Germany. Helmut Kohl, present Prime Minister. Chou En Lai was China. Robert Mugabe was Zimbabwe or Rhodesia. Charles Hohe, again, was Ireland. Francisco Franco, audience? Even they? Oh, good. Spain, was what we wanted. And Ayatollah Khomeini, of course, was Iran or Persia. However, at the end of that round, four right for you gives you £40. Whoever's taking at the moment. That's what it is. Barbara Branham, and you're from Shaw, Lancashire.
That's right.
Now, Paul, what's your occupation? What do you do?
We make flexographic printing plates.
Now, how does that differ from ordinary printing plates?
They are rubber printing plates.
Uh-huh. And Barbara, you don't go to work still, do you? I see. No. Two children, just enough work for you. I mean, and what attracted you to him then, Barbara? I mean, did you trip over him or something? I mean, what was it?
He was lying on his back at the time.
And he says here, wait a minute, the stories differ a bit. It says here that you were picked up at a dance.
That's right, yes.
Yeah? Yeah, no, he picked me up.
Oh, you picked her up, is that right? Now, were you drunk or was he drunk?
He was drunk.
I was put out of the gents at the time.
Oh, what a romantic start that was. However, let's have your questions. Thanks, Tina. The last envelope, of course, means they're your questions. Thank you. So, again, for £10 for each correct answer. You have your question is about international statesmen and politicians and their countries. We will give you the name of the politician. You give us the country. Bob Hawke has recently become Prime Minister of Australia. We'll start you with that one. Bob Hawke and?
Australia.
Richard Nixon.
America.
Nikita Khrushchev.
Pass.
Fidel Castro.
Cuba.
Menachem Begin.
Pass.
Garrett Fitzgerald.
Pass.
Ian Smith.
South Africa.
Ah, no. We can't accept that. I'm afraid it was Rhodesia. Or Zimbabwe, not South Africa. Different country, I'm afraid. Garrett Fitzgerald was Ireland, Republic of Ireland. Menachem Begin was Israel. And Nikita Khrushchev was Russia, but not bad at all. Three gives you £30. It's still pretty even. That's very even. Yeah, indeed. So, at the moment, we do have couple number three. That's Paul and Barbara. They have £30, but sharing the lead at the moment are couples number one and number two, both on £40 each. And off we go then, Brenda and Barry. You're going for £40 for each correct answer. Make another return to our show this week. Karen David is back with us. Karen, how are you?
All right, thank you, Ted.
Good. And we like that.
Thank you.
That's nice. Lovely outfit. Would you like to take one of those three, please? Okay. Thank you very much, Karen. So £40 for each correct answer. Second round question is about words in standard dictionaries which begin with the letters E-S. We will give you a definition. We want you to give us the word. Words beginning with E-S. An heraldic shield is an escutcheon. We'll start you with that one. Heraldic shield is?
Escutcheon.
A moving staircase.
Escalator.
Wide mouth of a river.
I don't know.
Act of getting away.
Escape.
Piece of written homework.
Don't know.
A wild adventure.
Don't know.
A title placed after a man's name.
Esquire.
Currency of Portugal.
Don't know.
Act of spying.
Espionage.
A fruit tree against a wall.
Don't know.
Right on the button, espalier was what we wanted there, espalier. The currency of Portugal was an escudo. Yes, you know, after the bell. It's always the way. A wild adventure was an escapade. Piece of written homework was an essay. And the wide mouth of a river was an estuary. Now you know, you've got £200 at the end of the second round. Not bad. £200. So, Sharon, Jackie and Martin, second round. Which one's yours? That's the one, thank you. So again, £40 for each correct answer for you. Holding very tight there. The question is about words in standard dictionaries which begin with the letters C-A. We will give you a definition. We want you to give us the word. Words beginning with C-A. A table showing the days and months is a calendar. So we'll start you with that one. Table showing the days and months is a...
calendar.
Small log hut.
Cabin.
A young cow.
Pass.
A taxi.
Cab.
West Coast State of America.
Pass.
Popular West Indian ballad.
Pass.
Strong, thick rope.
Pass.
A small restaurant.
Calf.
Enclosure in a zoo.
Pass.
A hidden store.
Pass.
Yes, quite a tough one. Never mind, you didn't bat. Tried on that one. Cash was what we wanted. C-A-C-H-E, cash. An enclosure in a zoo was a cage. Oh. Yes, strong thick rope was cable. Popular West Indian ballad, Calypso. And a West Coast state of America. California, yes. A young cow was a calf. So at the end of that, you've got £160 you got at the end of that. 160. So, okay, Karen, thank you. Last envelope is for Paul and Barbara, who are on £30 for each correct answer. And again, your question is about words in standard dictionaries which begin with the letters P-E. We will give you a definition. We want you to give us the word. Words beginning with P-E. Now, a board that conceals a curtain rail is a pelmet. We'll start you with that one. Board that conceals a curtain rail is a...
pelmet.
A small British bronze coin.
Penny.
A black and white swimming bird.
Pass.
A gem found in an oyster.
Pearl.
Pointed top of a mountain.
Pass.
Skin of an orange.
Peel.
Jewel hanging on a chain.
Pearl.
No. Pendant was what we wanted, yes? Yes, I'm afraid we do have to accept that one. Pendant was the answer we were after. The pearl was the found in the oyster, of course. Her pointed top of a mountain was a peak. And the black and white swimming bird was a penguin, it was what it was. But you, at the end of that, have got £120. You got? 120. Paul says, don't worry, you're absolutely right not to worry. You've been a delight to have here. So the two words given to each of our couples this week spell out E-S-C-A-P-E, escape, tying in with this week's theme of the Lilac Pimpernel. But at the end of our quiz this week, we do in fact have couple number three, it's Paul and Barbara on £120. Couple number two, Jacqueline and Martin, have £160. The winners are couple number one up there. They've got £200. That's Brenda and Barry. Brenda and Barry. Lovely. I think it's rather nice like that. Oh, I am sorry. He says, oh, don't worry about it. It's one of those things you have the right to answer or say pass, don't know. However, you have been nice to have here. Have you enjoyed being with us?
Super.
There you are. There's the £120 and there's that ceramic dusty bin. I'm sure that's going to be very welcome, isn't it, Barbara?
Yes, thank
thanks very much for coming along. Take care. All the best to you, Paul.
Thanks,
give him a round of applause, folks. Lovely couple. Thank you very much. Here we have it. And, of course, it's time for us to just go away for a couple of minutes. We'll see you soon on 3-2-1. Come back shortly. Indeed, welcome to 3-2-1, our theme of the Lilac Pimpernel. We have Barry and Brenda Haller, who are from Aylesbury, and we have Martin and Jacqueline Reeve, who are from Coggeshall, near Colchester.
ready to be with us right through part two. Now, you know what happens at the end of each item we show you here? One of the characters comes to the table, leads a clue object, and has a rhyme for you. When we've got three on the table, I shall ask each couple to select one they'd like to reject, if they're going to be that fortunate couple to get through and hopefully take home a good prize and ignore that little dusty bin. OK? Good luck to you. Let's get on with our first item then on the Lilac Pimpernel. The year is 1790, and we drop in at the room of Sir Percy Blakeney's London home.
Charmed. Je m'appelle Armand Saint-Just.
If you please, sir, the king's English.
Well, of course the king is English.
Foreigner, yeah.
Monsieur, I must see Sir Percy Blakeney at once. It is a matter of life and death.
Oh, odds fish. Major Domo, is Sir Percy free yet?
I'm free.
Percy, lad, sir, you have the finest balls in London.
Oh, step me vitals, odds bodikins, what have we here?
Sir Percy, thank heavens I'm in time. Armand Saint-Just.
Just in time.
I have come from France especially to find you.
Oh, it must be my lucky day.
I must be with you, how you say, alone.
It's getting better.
Sir Percy, I must see your Pimpernel.
There's a time and a place for everything. I must tell you that the Pimpernel this very night sails for France. Oh,
I know. He intends to rescue my sister, Marguerite, but he will be walking into a trap.
Oh, in that case, I must tell you that I am the Pimpernel.
Mais non.
Mais oui.
It is not possible. The Pimpernel is known to be a man of huge proportions.
Yes, well, I don't want to boast.
The Pimpernel is tall, strong, muscular. He is a Samson amongst men.
Yes, well, it's my day off. Shall we give the lad a demonstration?
Oh, yes, why?
Screens, screen. Andrew, pass me my Dorothy bag.
Indeed, I will.
Mm-hmm. Ah. Now, young man, watch this very closely.
Oh, I love this. Here we are,
They seek him here, they seek him there.
Those Frenchies seek him everywhere.
Is he in heaven?
Or is he in hell? That damned elusive Pimpernel.
Oh, bravo, Sir Percy. Oh, fun.
C'est incroyable. You are a changed man.
I wouldn't rely on it.
It is true what they say. The Pimpernel is not like other men.
Yes, so I've heard. Yeah.
Yes. Well, I must change at once. We don't want to frighten the ladies. What?
No, indeed.
They seek him here. They seek him there.
Those Frenchies seek him everywhere.
Is he in heaven?
Or is he in hell? That damned elusive Pimpernel.
Oh, how bravo. Does he do it? Wonderful.
Getting into disguises can be very difficult, but I never have any trouble getting them off.
Yes, so I've heard.
Well, young man, are you convinced?
Oui, monsieur.
Well, it's been rejected. Take it away. Tell me of this ambush.
Ah, oui. It is that fiend Chauvelin. He has laid a deadly and impenetrable trap for you.
Deadly?
Fatal.
In that case, can you give me one good reason why I should even consider crossing the channel?
Monsieur le Pimpernel.
Well, that's a start.
Bring my sister safely from France, and I swear I will dedicate my life to your service.
Oh, I do like a boy that wants to get on. Come on, chaps, before we lose the tide. Now, how's your mother been keeping?
There he is. Tyler Butterworth. There you are. That should give you some kind of clue who this gentleman is. Tyler Butterworth is his name. And can I tell him who your folks are?
Yes.
Yes, his dad was that great actor from the Carry On series, Peter Butterworth, and his mum is Janet Brown. There you are, there you are. Hey. Good to have you with us, Tyler.
Thank you.
Hey, listen, and what are you doing? You're really into acting, huh?
Yeah, well, this is my first job.
Well,
my
first job.
I'm enjoying it, yeah.
There you are, you see. Hi.
Great.
You're coming in. Good for you. Lovely to have you with us. We met a long, long time ago, but I won't bring up how long ago that was.
It'll be long.
You were like that in those days. Anyway, what are you leaving these folks,
right,
Tyler?
Well, I'm leaving a quill.
The quill is the clue, yeah? And how about the rhyme?
The rhyme. A pen and ink might fit well here if you get to thinking right. If you want to take it, easy. It's back to the old school tonight.
Mm. How about that, Brenda?
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, my goodness. How about you, Jackie? Well, she's gone in after something.
Writing desk.
Oh, well, you heard her say that, didn't you?
Yeah.
Yes, well, it's
the antique theme.
Yeah,
in.
Good. Well, have a word with he might.
Oh, is he?
Yeah, he is there. He's not left you yet. We're going to thank Tyler Butterworth. Thank you, Tyler. Good luck.
Good luck. Good luck.
That's good. At least you're thinking in the right direction. That's what you think it is at the moment, huh? I'm sure that's going to change as you hear the ones come up. However, we will go on right now and have item number two. And once again, we join our intrepid trio on the high seas, bound for France.
I must say that journey down to Folkestone with young Aaron proved most rewarding.
Yes, I've heard.
Yeah? Have you seen that evil French peasant Chevalin?
Ooh!
Shh! Has imprisoned Marguerite in a windowless cell.
Ooh.
Be quiet. The door being the only way in has been linked to a barbarous device.
Ooh.
Which means instant death to anyone who tries to open it unless they've got a special door key which Chauvelin wears round his neck.
Ooh.
Will you please stop booing?
I was not booing. I was trying to say... Boo-loin' ahead!
Oh, just let you can stay and mend the boat.
Mend it? How am I supposed to do that?
Here, I'll lend you my puncture outfit. Come on.
Hey, George. Good to see you. Hey, listen, it's a splendid comedy actor, of course, but you do many things. You direct as well, I understand.
I directed pantomime, written by Chris Emmett.
Chris Emmett's pantomime,
yes. Which was 100% sellout, and I write a lot.
What are you going to leave then, George?
Well,
clue?
There you are, a ship's lantern.
Ship's lantern is the clue.
Or the ship's lantern.
The ship's lantern. Okay, and the rhyme?
If you want to finish around par, is this the thing you need? You might be insane if you take it, and on it, we'll all be agreed.
Now, pretty quick last time, Jackie. What do you say this time?
Golf.
Well, golf, she says. Oh, Brenda?
Oh, yes.
Mm.
Oh, God.
Mm.
The ship's lantern.
Yeah. That goes in a golf bag quite well, doesn't it? All right, let's thank George.
Okay.
Good luck, George.
Good luck.
Thank you for coming. Bye-bye now. Well, what I'm pleased about tonight, at least you're thinking straight away, which is rather nice. We have one more on the table before we have to see who goes through to part three. What do you say, Martin? You still thinking about that?
Yes, I am. I'm pumping and ending at the moment.
Nothing at all.
It's well, a lantern.
It's throwing you?
Yeah.
All right.
It might not be.
Well, I'll tell you what, when we have the next one in, again, you'll have a chance of hearing both of these again to refresh your memories. Right, so item number three, after the crash landing on the French shore, we find our intrepid heroes at Chauvelin's favourite bordello.
So there he is.
Yes, Chauvelin himself.
How do you know where to find him?
Yes, well, the last time I was in France, I had a chat with that nasty little assistant of his, Monsieur Degas, and I, shall we say, forced it out of him.
How?
Oh, a packet of Dolly Mitchell's and his anybody's. Listen, pass me my donkey bag. I'm just going into action. I've got time to change before the cabaret.
Right. Bon chance.
Yes.
And now, the highlight of your entertainment. We bring you the proud, the pure, the prestige, the provocative, Mademoiselle Lillian!
Now, I'm sure I know what you're all thinking. Confronted with beauty like this, you're willing to bet I'm Marie Antoinette. I'll have none of you taking the mirror. Don't be confused by this beauty, or this air of an innocent child. I may look quite gracious, but I'm really rapacious, because I'm in the business of deriding you. I'm such a treasure, I believe, in your pleasure I am known at every hotel. I'm a stealthy girl, I'm a well-esteemed girl, I'm a cheerful girl.
for France. When men take a chance with me, they're soon falling under ice. I'm a faithful girl, who's a grateful girl? I'm a jest. My reputation's in some doubt, but most of it's simply hearsay. Any night you'd like to check me out, you'll find me walking up and down the Champs-Élysées. That after one night with me, you will declare, who didn't she do well? I'm a hurtful girl, I'm a shameful girl, I did some well. I'm coming up to the giving people big surprises. You'll get a big surprise, I guess, when we offer got an offer underneath this dress. Dicky, and you feel a little dicky, and it's hard when you're poorly as well. Faithful girl, who's a faithful girl? I'm a jazz, 2, 3, 4, it's 2, 3, 4, bell.
Sir Norman de Chapel.
Nice to see you.
How are you, Norman?
Fine.
Good to see you. Thanks again for calling back with us here. Lovely. Up at 321. Been with us many times. And again, like George Layton, you're going into writing in a big way.
Yes, I've co-written a play with Ron Hodgkinson, and we're shortly to tour Australia.
Love it. Are you in the play as well?
Yes, yes.
Fabulous. Great. Looking forward to that, I bet.
Yes.
It's a terrific country. Have a good time, Norman.
Where
are you going to leave these folks?
Well, these are the Bastille Keys.
Mm-hmm. The Bastille Keys.
I expect you'd like the rhyme, wouldn't you?
Would you?
Chauvelin's dungeon is way underground and hidden within a big cavern. You'd best make a start or you'll land in the cart, but not coming back from the tavern. Here we are. Best of luck.
Indeed. Norman Chapel. Good luck in Australia, Norman. The Bastille Keys. What do you think?
I think it's wine, because underneath the ground, a wine cellar.
Wine cellar?
Yeah.
And he thinks it was a car, and you think it's wine?
Wine cellar.
But I think that was a car.
Well, we have three on the table. You've just heard that from Norman. Again, I'm allowed to read both of these again. So here was the quill brought in number one item by Tyler Butterworth, who said, a pen and ink might fit well here if you get to thinking right. If you want to take it easy, it's back to the old school tonight. Yes. Tyler said that. And, of course, the ship's lantern brought in by number two item by George Layton, who said, if you want to finish around par, is this the thing you need? You might be insane if you take it, and on it we'll all be agreed. So, what do you say?
Very tough. Mm-hmm. I thought it was a cow, but insane to take it.
See, when you hear them another time, yes, they are just a little bit different, eh?
And it's an oil lamp. It could be oil that goes into a car.
Puncher outfits or puncher goes.
Yeah, just a little bit devious, wouldn't you say? Okay, folks, we've got three
dangerous
on the table. Yes, indeed. Dangerous, and what do you say? One's got to go.
I think the feather.
I think the feather.
You want to reject the feather if you get through? And Barry and Brenda, how about you?
I think...
Yes, the feather.
We would reject the feather.
You would?
Yes.
Sure. All right. Yes. That's absolutely unanimous then. Whoever goes through, the quill is going. Right? Here we have the elimination question, you know. You've got the button there. Put your hands beside that button. When I start to read the question here, if you think you know the answer, hit the button and answer. If you do answer before hitting the button, I must offer it to the other couple. Of course, if they're wrong, again, we'll keep going until we get it right. Good luck to you. Here's the question. This is a flower, and it's also called poor man's weather glass. It can be red, pink, or blue. Yes, indeed. Martin?
Pimpernel.
Sorry?
Pimpernel.
The pimpernel was right. Sorry. Well done, Jackie. Yes, you got it. Yeah. Oh. Well done, Jackie. You see, you hit that so hard, I asked Martin, but it was you. Very, very quick. You see, again, you have... I know, you have the option of hitting and answering. You were right. You were wrong, of course. I could have thrown it to you. If you'd have got it, you would have been through. That's the way it goes, though. Congratulations. We have to say goodbye to Barry and Brenda right now. But Tina's here with the money from the quiz, which was what?
£200.
That was £200. That was what it was. And there is that ceramic dusty bin. And Brenda and Barry, if you'd just like to take a look across there, Tyler Butterworth has a consolation prize for you. There's 5 bottles of champagne and there's crystal flute glasses. There's 6 of those as well. What a consolation.
Crystal fluted glasses.
Thank you, Brenda. Take care. All the best. Thanks very much, Barry. Super. Take care. Give them a round of applause, folks. Take care. Bye-bye now. All the best. Take care. Well done, Jackie. It was so quick. I thought it was Martin had answered, but it was you. And good for you for taking the chance, which means, of course, you're 3 through. Hopefully to take home that good prize. We know what it is you've rejected, the quill. We'll be back after the break to see exactly what this is. See you in a minute. Thank you. Welcome to part 3 of 3-2-1. This week's theme is the Lilac Pimpernel, and we've got Martin and Jackie Reeve, who are from Coggeshall near Colchester. They've won the right to get through to part 3 and hopefully take home a good prize. You've rejected the quill brought in by Tyler Butterworth. What do you think it is?
Writing desk.
You think it's a writing desk? Well, he said a pen and ink might fit well here if you get to thinking right. If you want to take it easy, it's back to the old school tonight. So, is it a desk? Is it a bin? Keep them crossed. A pen and ink might fit well here. Well, pen and ink is rhyming slang for stink, so that could indicate dusty bin. If you get to thinking right, right could also mean correct, but right, as you suggest, would also have a connection with writing. Perhaps then pen and ink fitting well could mean ink well, which would make you think of desk, and indeed it did, I think. If you want to take it easy, taking it easy might involve a chair, which could go with the desk. It's back to the old school tonight. Well, a chair and a desk have a connection with school, and the old school should indicate an antique collection, which fits in with the quill and the pen which Tyler brought you in. In fact, you're absolutely right. This reproduction Regency-style desk chair that would fit into any room. Have a look at this. Well, now, Jackie, Martin. Yes, you were right about writing this, but not a little bit better than maybe the one you had in mind. It's a terrific prize, right?
Yes.
A lot of money, being a 3-2-1 prize, of course. It's been rejected, but the bin hasn't got you. He's the one we've got to look out for, OK? Get your thinking caps on of that dusty bin. We will go on right now and have item number 4. For this, we do go back to Paris. More fun with Sir Percy and Anthony, this time in the dungeons below the Bastille.
Hens.
Look at that. Stack me vitals.
Yeah, it would do if it dropped on them.
How's it triggered off?
Simply by opening the door unless you possess the key which disarms the mechanism.
Then how on earth?
Quick.
It's 3:15. There's no one in the place except you and me. Hello, little prisoner. Oh, Red Eyes is back. Oh, look, an eye-level grill. It's the way I tell them, you know. Hello, little prisoner, can you hear me in there? Speak to Quasi. Dibble! Dibble! Maybe it's somebody at the front door. I hope it's the oven, young lady. I'm nearly out of the last lock she brought. Half time, Nikita.
We don't have much time.
Yes, but we need Chauvelin's key.
Ah, you mean this?
I saw him take it from you.
Yes, that's right, but don't worry, I'll explain it later. Now, let's get this open.
Oh, look, it's trembling.
It's not the only thing that's trembling. Now, keep a lookout.
Right.
Kiella.
Mademoiselle, the Lilac Pimpernel. We've come to take you to England.
Quickly!
Stop! You need the key.
Oh, my dear lady, the door is unlocked.
No. The key must be in the lock when the door is open. Otherwise,
you get a nasty mess in the doorstep. Damn Chauvelin's full of surprises. I've got some prize for him, though. There, leave that there. Come on, let's go. Don't want to waste time. Back to the yacht.
I am free. I am free. I'm free.
Say that once again, dear. You're back inside. Come on, quick.
This way. This way, master. This way. No, he's free! Oh, yes, master, please wipe the feet, wipe the feet!
Quickly, you idiot!
Pushing me around all the time, all you do is push, push, push! Here we go into the cell, here we go into the cell, here we go in, here we go in, here we go into the cell!
And where is the prisoner, Peabody?
Oh, the Peabody. Sticks and stones may break my bones, but maybe, look this. Maybe she's wrapped herself up for the night.
Give it to me. What is this? A present for Monsieur Chauvelin. Open at once. Open
happy birthday to...
What is this inside? It's a rhyme.
Oh, that's very odd. How could we reject the prisoner before we've read the rhyme?
Shut up!
Oh, shut up.
How did I do it, I hear you exclaim. The answer's the wax aid I used as a dame.
The dame?
Examine the right one you have in your hand.
It's the right one.
A glance at the surface and you'll understand.
Understand.
Pressing so close in your ardor to me, you gave me the perfect impression of the key. I expect, my dear Chauvelin, you'll now have a fit.
Fit?
At the Pimpernel making you look...
And I twit!
After him!
After him, yes!
The key!
What key?
Alan Stewart is here.
Hello.
Oh, yeah. All right.
Hello. Yeah.
This is
the real me now.
Real you. That's Alan Stewart, a very talented fella. Introduced to you a long time ago, Sunday night, the played him. I'll never forget that.
Do you remember?
Yes, I do.
I was only a boy.
Yeah, do it. Well, 9 years ago already. Yeah. But you're all around the world doing all sorts of things, and you're off on a good jaunt tomorrow.
Yep, QE2 for 2 weeks.
QE2 for two. And where are you going now?
We're going to the Canary Islands, and it's the TV Times cruise, it should be.
Really?
Really difficult.
Is it? Some people get all the rough jobs, don't they? Lovely. Good to have you with us. What are you going to leave them with the clue?
A metal weight.
Metal weight? How about
the clue? The weight it fell from up above, it's gravity, you know, and quasi's feeling rather flat. Will you fall or let it go?
Hey, Jackie. A bit quick earlier on, it's getting a bit uneasy now, isn't it? However, we're going to thank Alan Stewart, and good luck on the trip, Alan. Have a good time.
Thanks.
Thanks for coming up here. Metal weight from Alan Stewart. Any idea what you think that could be?
I think it would be a weight off my mind if I got rid of it.
Yeah.
Sorry?
So it could be the bin.
Could be the bin. Well, I tell you what, I can read these two again. Either one of these two, not both of them. I can read one again. The Bastille Keys, brought in, of course, by Norman Chapel, or the Ship's Lantern, brought in by George Layton. Which of these two would you like to hear?
I'd like to hear the keys, please.
The keys? Yes. Okay. The Bastille Keys, brought in by Norman Chapel, who said, Chauvelin's dungeon is way underground and hidden within a big cavern. You'd best make a start, or you'll land in the cart, but not coming back from the tavern. So?
I think the keys might be the car, so I'll keep that.
Oh.
And the lantern,
it's
I don't
underground.
Know.
Underground.
Yeah, the lantern you don't know, and the metal weight that Alan just brought in. Any idea?
Could be a weight off your mind.
Uh-huh. Could be a weight off your mind. Yeah. It could all be a weight off your mind, wouldn't it? Okay, which one's going to go, Jackie?
I think the weight.
You're going to get rid of the weight, yes?
Yeah.
Yes.
All right, then. So the metal weight is going that was just brought in by Alan Stewart, who said, the weight it fell from up above, it's gravity, you know. And quasi's feeling rather flat. Will you fall or will it go? So, we know what your hope it is. Will it go? Could be a car. I've opened it now. It's got to go, I'm afraid. Whatever it is, Martin, it has to go. The weight it fell from up above, does this mean that your hopes could fall here after all the weight that Alan left? It was metal, of course. It's gravity, you know. Well, it would be quite a grave situation if you were to win Dusty Bin, and quasi's feeling rather flat. Well, flat could mean depressed, but it could also mean something else. Perhaps a holiday apartment. Will you fall or will it go? Well, that implies that if you don't let it go, you will fall. It's gone, you've done it, Dusty Bin, yeah! However, you're in the good position now. A good prize goes home with you tonight. You've rejected the bin, so we will go on right now and have item number 5. The Lilac Pimpernel. Again, we go back to London. Another ball is being held at Sir Percy Blakeley's home, but there's no sign of our host or the lovely Marguerite.
Oh, I don't believe it.
Monsieur, where is my sister?
No idea, sir. We parted company in Folkestone.
Tush, sir, don't worry. She'll be quite safe in our leader's hands.
Yes, so I've heard.
My lords, ladies, honored guests, Sir Percy and Lady Blakeney.
Lady Blakeney? No, it's me. I've just had my hair done.
You mean you married her?
Well, I told you, I don't believe in wasting time.
Yes, but I always thought...
Yes, I've heard.
Father-in-law, I salute you.
No, you can cut that out. We're back in England now.
Leave the boy alone. He knows what he's doing. After all, we're one big happy family now.
My lords, ladies, honored guests, Monsieur Chavalot.
There.
Clearly, Sir Percy, you are in league with this Lilac Pimpernel. This lady's presence is proof enough of this. And so is that.
What is it?
My head jailer, Quasimodo.
Looks more like a squashimodo. Why don't you have him stuffed?
You have had your fun, messieurs, at the expense of my beloved France.
Oh, vive la France.
La République de la France. But I swear if it takes me the rest of my life, I shall bring this most bitter enemy face to face with Madame Guillotine.
No balderdash.
And then I shall have, how you say, the last laugh.
You, monsieur, are, how you say, an old stick in the mud. A word in votre ero. I see, by the look on your face...
Comment?
...that you're feeling so out of place.
You see?
In a world that seems so full of fun to me.
Zut alors!
I'll show you what a wonderful world it can be.
Gratitude the world will guarantee
that you'll find it's a wonderful place to be. You'll find it fulfilling if you will be willing to take this fortune on the chin.
It may sound alarming, but you could be charming.
He only takes the slightest grin. My friend,
to see you.
Indeed.
Nice to see you.
What about that? I should give that a saucer of milk.
I know, it's wonderful. I had it done in a pressure cooker.
Good to see you, John. Listen, you've made a few trips across the channel tonight, but I know you're going there again for the summer, aren't you?
I'm going to Jersey. To
where are you playing? St. Helier.
The Opera House St. Helier, yes. I'm looking forward to it.
And is it a summer show or is it a play you're doing?
It's a play. It's a farce, yes. I'm doing, yes. And great. I shall be there for 20 weeks.
Well, you have a lot of fun there. It's a great place to play.
Oh, I'm looking forward to it.
Good. And what are you going to leave these folks?
Now, something terrible, really. A cutthroat razor.
Oh, yes, cutthroat razor.
Yes. You might put all the pieces in here, or should you give it the chop, you'll find a few in any canteen. At the table, it's at the top.
There you are. That's the last one. At least the bin has gone. Let's thank John Inman and good luck in Jersey, you, John. Thanks for calling. Thank you, John. Well.
Bin's in on top of the
table.
Uh-huh. Well, he says it could be a canteen of cutlery, and you say it could be things you put in a... whatever. We've got two on the table here. I can read either one of these two again. What would you like to hear? The keys, of course, the Bastille keys brought in by Norman Chappell, or the ship's lantern, which was brought in by George Layton. Which one do you want to hear?
Do you want to hear ship's lantern?
Yeah.
Yes? OK, you did hear the keys, didn't you? OK, George Layton said, if you want to finish around par, is this the thing you need? You might be insane if you take it, or on it we'll all be agreed. And on it we'll all be agreed. So.
I think we keep the lantern and keys, and we don't know what the...
Cutthroat.
No, you can't, I'm afraid. No, you can't hear two.
I think we get rid of the cutthroat.
Yes. Yes. The one that John just brought in?
Yes.
Okay, so the cutthroat razor John Inman just brought you in. You might put all the pieces in here, or should you give it the chop, you'll find a few in any canteen at the table. It's at the top, is what John Inman said. You put all the pieces in here. Well, of course, you could put them in a bin, but you know he's gone. You won't worry about that anymore. Or should you give it the chop? Well, the chop together with the cutthroat razor might have made you think of some sort of cutting implements, as indeed it did, Jackie. Or you'll find a few in any canteen should have made you think of cutlery, as again it did, particularly when we said at the table, it's at the top. But this isn't just a canteen of cutlery made by one of the country's leading silversmiths in Sheffield steel. 12-piece place setting of canteen silver cutlery housed in this fabulous mahogany cabinet. Take a look at this.
Wow. Look at that. There you are.
There you are. Quite a sensational prize,
think
I think.
All
the polishing. Think of all the eating you could do with that, though. What a fabulous prize it is. Again, it's been rejected. It has to go. We're down to the final two now. We know you go home with a good prize tonight. Both these, I can read again now. We have two. Ship's lantern brought in by George Layton. If you want to finish around par, is this the thing you need? You might be insane if you take it, and on it we'll all be agreed. And the Bastille keys brought in. Number three by Norman Chappell. He said, Chauvelin's dungeon is way underground and hidden within a big cavern. You'd best make a start or you'll land in the cart, but not coming back from the tavern. So, what do you say?
I think that's underground. French underground metro could be a car.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's holiday.
Yeah? Well...
What do you think?
She keeps trying to convince me, you know, Martin. Yes. What about you?
I agree with that. I think get rid of the lantern.
All right, then, the ship's lantern brought in by George Layton. If you want to finish around par, is this the thing you need? You might be insane if you take it, and on it, we'll all be agreed, is what George said. So, are you right again in your assumption? You've been pretty good tonight. George Layton brought you in the ship's lantern. That might mean some sort of sea trip. If you want to finish around par, is this the thing you need? Well, of course, in those lines, you have par and is consecutively. If you put those together, Parrish, you were right there. You might be insane if you take it. That doesn't sound too good. The be and in, it does when he's gone, but the river of Paris, as you said, on the Seine, and if the weather was hot enough, you might even want to take a dip in the Seine, and on it we'll all be agreed. Nobody can go to Paris without having a trip on the Seine. The sea trip was a channel crossing, right, a 3-2-1 holiday to Paris. That's what it was. Look at this. Jackie and Martin, not Blackpool, Paris, and 7 nights in a 4-star hotel in the heart of the romantic city. A chance to explore the history and beauty and sample the atmosphere of that French capital. To visit all the breathtaking sights such as the Palace of Versailles and a reminder of a past age of elegance. Plenty of opportunity for a world-famous nightlife in Paris, including dinner and cabaret at one of the city's leading night spots. Also, the quieter side of Paris by night, too. And evening river and sightseeing cruises were to be yours as you would have experienced Paris 3-2-1 style. Fabulous holiday. And of course, you have rejected it. There you are. But, has to go. Well, I say, you've been absolutely terrific tonight. You've been pretty right on all of them. This is the one you're going to take home with you, the prize, the Bastille keys, brought in by Norman Chappell. Chauvelin's dungeon is way underground and hidden within a big cavern. You'd best make a start or you'll land in the cart, but not coming back from the tavern. So, what is it? Chauvelin's dungeon, that's it, hold each other tight. Chauvelin's dungeon is way underground. Chauvelin was French, so the underground, again you got that. If French might have made you think of resistance, talk of dungeons, gloomy, the bin, not anymore. Hidden within a big cavern contains the letters B-I at the start and N, but we said hidden within a big cavern. And among other things, you'll find the letter C-A-R in three, in there.
You best make a start or you'll land in the cart. Start could have a connection with a car, as could the older form of transport, the cart. But not coming back from the tavern. Well, you shouldn't be driving cars back from the tavern, so that's another clue there. We've got the keys for the other French underground, right, the British Leyland Mini Metro. You got it. Okay, Jackie, Martin, off we go. Come along, Martin. Okay, Nicky. Jackie, come round here with me, will you? There we are. Oh, marvellous. There we are, Jackie, it's yours. Congratulations, absolutely marvellous. You won't believe this, they were going to go out to buy one of these cars. Good luck to you on that. But don't forget, you have money you won in the quiz. Now, Karen David has that. I'm not sure exactly what it was. Karen, how much was it?
£160.
It was £160. There it is. Congratulations. Well, now, there you have it. Ladies and gentlemen, marvellous people, what a way to go out at the end of our series. At this moment, I'd like to thank all the crew, all the folks, the staff up here at Yorkshire. Thank all of our guests, all of our contestants, without whom we just wouldn't have a show. But most of all, thank you for watching our show and putting it up there high in the ratings each week. Until we see you in December, take care. Have a good summer, everybody. Bye-bye. Good night, everyone.